Vaccines are required if you're headed to war, but Target 5 discovered that a frightening number of U.S. servicemen and women are having severe reactions, including a young Marine from Claremont County.
It's difficult right now.
At a time when young men and women are dying on the battlefield.
We live in a very volatile time in the military.
There is an enemy here at home.
And no one wants to look bad.
It's not a shot from a gun.
This is the worst cover-up in the history of the military.
But a shot from a syringe that's leaving some U.S. servicemen and women on the brink of death.
When the issue, I believe, of the use of the vaccine comes out, I believe it'll make the Walter Reed scandal pale in comparison.
It's an exhausting three-day-a-week routine for 20-year-old Lance Corporal David Fay of Claremont County. His kidneys are failing, his military career is over, and he feels like his country has abandoned him.
I can't look at my old pictures. I really can't. I start looking at my old pictures and I start crying.
To understand the odyssey of David Fay requires going back in time. He was a boy who loved the ocean, but grew up amid the farm fields of Claremont County.
I never missed a day of school. I was never sick.
A passion for sports and a sense of patriotism prompted this Blanchester High School athlete to join the Marines on his 18th birthday.
And I looked at every branch, but I wanted the Marine Corps because the Marine Corps was the few of the proud.
From boot camp to combat training, it was the happiest time of his life.
It was great. I loved every minute of it.
But a case of friendly fire in the form of a syringe would forever change his life. On November 28th of 2005, David's unit was lined up for what he says was an undisclosed shot.
They asked us our name. We stood on these yellow footprints, and they gave us a shot. And we got the rest of the day off. After that shot, I started swelling up. I gained 30 pounds of water. My eyes swelled up where I couldn't see. I started snoring. I developed a rash on my hand.
3 weeks later, Private Fay was back in Claremont County on his deathbed at Clinton Memorial Hospital. His kidneys failing, his body so swollen it left stretch marks.
I used to just pray to God, please take him tonight.
As David appeared to be dying, Cindy Fay began poring over his military medical records in search of answers.
The shot was never listed in his records.
As the months passed by, David's uniform would hang in the closet while his life would hang in the balance. Still unclear about the shot he was given on November 28th of 2005. The Department of Defense tells Target 5 all service members' vaccinations are documented in the individual's permanent medical record. But David Fay's military medical records revealed no shot on that day. Another Marine in David's unit tells Target 5 there's no shot listed in his medical records either, and goes on to say the people who administered the shot never told us what it was.
My son is a Marine, a PFC, David Fay, and he
in a desperate attempt to save her dying son, Cindy says she called the U.S. Marine Hospital at 29 Palms, California, to find out what kind of vaccine her son was given.
And she says, ma'am, that's confidential. I can't tell you what the shot was. And I'm like, well, my son's in ICU and he might not make it right now. I said, I really need to know. And she says, well, we can't tell you.
11 months later, David's medical records were mysteriously changed with a handwritten notation indicating the mystery shot was a flu vaccine.
The case of David Fay, nothing was put on his record. And then suddenly, flu vaccine appears on his record. Does that surprise you?
No. No, we have a lovely term for that. We call it CYA. That's, unfortunately, an SOP in the military.
David is one of a growing number of U.S. servicemen and women getting sick after receiving vaccines. And this highly praised Department of Defense medical officer is mortified. He doesn't want to be identified for fear of retribution.
Are there a lot of folks out there who've had severe reactions to these vaccines?
Thousands. It ranging on the severity from just joint aches and pains and arthritic symptoms to death.
The Department of Defense tells Target 5 it encourages healthcare workers and vaccine recipients to report adverse events. but the military never reported David Fay's reaction to the Centers for Disease Control and FDA.
I see the way propaganda and information war is waged against America's sons and daughters, and how patients are treated who claim to be ill from a vaccine. That's troubling. That should trouble America.
How are these young men and women treated when they claim to have had a reaction to the vaccine?
Like they're nuts, like it's all in their head.
And this medical officer believes young servicemen and women are being used as guinea pigs.
Do you believe that the Department of Defense is experimenting on these servicemen and women with these vaccinations?
I would hope to God not, but from what I've seen, I would have to say yes.
The Department of Defense maintains the vaccines are safe and effective. Those are hollow words to Lance Corporal David Fay.
I'm in bed every single minute of the day. I can't eat because I throw up. I have no energy. I've been laying in bed, bedridden for so long.
4 months after that interview, David has lost 60 pounds from dialysis and is determined to rebuild his body and his life. Still waiting for a kidney transplant, still waiting for an answer from the U.S. military.
My biggest wish? Just to get up and be without pain. I mean, just to get up every day and just be happy again.
Even after everything David Fay has been through, he still longs to be a part of the U.S. Marines. David still considers himself part of the few and the proud, even though he feels the military has abandoned him. Dave Wagner, Target 5.